All right, so how many of you watched my recent top five video? I know, I did a bunch of them, right? But what I'm talking about is the top five TKL, the 10 keyless keyboard roundup right there. How many of you watched it? We have some dang good keyboards on there, but believe it or not, middle of testing that right there and kind of wrapping up that video, a keyboard came in that should have been on that video, if not at the number one spot. And that keyboard I'm talking about is the Ducky One 3 TKL. Something else that should have been on our list as well, kind of, I think, maybe not really, but that's a word from our sponsor, Rad and their electric bikes. Rad power bikes and a Rad Mini just scream quality right out of the box. Simple to assemble and high quality parts top to bottom. Featuring a fat tire design that would get you simply through any and over all terrain. Packing a 750 watt motor that will get you up to 20 miles per hour and up to 45 miles of range. And to top it all off, you can fold the Rad Mini electric bike in half, put it at the back of your vehicle, and take your electric bike with you no matter where your adventures go. Okay, so maybe that shouldn't have been on my top five TKL video, but it's stinking awesome, and I highly recommend you go check them out in the links down below. All right, so let's go on and get into the keyboard here, get our desk mat down. By the way, this is the Aqua Control 2 by X-Ray Pads. Links for this down in the description. Nice control pad, but popping open the keyboard. Again, you're gonna get presented by your keyboard first off, your little dust cover wrapped in plastic here. And just taking a first look at it, as you see, we have that pink and navy blue version. We're gonna dive even deeper into that, but taking a look at what you get in your box, little manual, good thing they went back to manuals here. Ducky's actually including stickers now. And as cheesy as it is, but I really like the inside of this box. It gives you like a switch breakdown, a linear and tactile kind of breakdown. Just really cool touch there. I don't know, tech nerd, I love it, right? As far as our accessories back here, you get your detachable USB-C cable, pink to match that, as far as whichever color you get, yours will match there. A switch puller, which we'll get more into that as well. And then some extra keycaps. Now this is really cool. So you got a bunch more of the dark pinks. Again, very thick PBT keycaps. And yeah, this little round ducky keycap. Wait, I think there's something else back there. Yes, our keycap puller. That matches the theme of our keyboard as well. All right, so let's go on and take a look at the keyboard right out of the box. Now, as far as this color theme, it does come in other ones as well, like a fully yellow one, a full blue one, this cool greenish one. But as far as ours here, again, we have that nice subtle kind of baby pink right there into a navy blue. As you can see, the font is that dark pink, just like this over here. Me not being a pink or blue fan, I really love the flow of this. It's kind of subtle, but still bold. I really like it. And as you see, flows right into the navy blue underneath. And then you have your two levels of pop-out feet. Pop-out feet are pink. You have your cable router and a USB-C port right in the middle if you can catch it right there. Come down over here, you have your dip switches and then four pads on all corners. Now, one thing I do want to show you as far as the build here, these little side decorative pieces that kind of swoop down, they look really cool, right? But anyways, they are not part of the bottom frame. That's a whole separate piece. And by the way, so what you can do is pop this out, bam, there's that piece I was talking about. And what's going on is you have two screws right here and they're just not tightened all the way down. So again, if you have that issue with that thing rattling, my other side was actually much worse, but I tightened it up and it doesn't do it anymore. And one other thing that really surprised me with this board here is just the loftiness of it. I mean, you feel like you have a premium product in your hand. When you slap it down on a scale here, we can get 2 pounds, 4.2 ounces. And let me tell you what, this keyboard, like no joke, you feel like you got a premium product, which is not the vibe we really got with the Ducky One 2s, in my personal opinion. Now the version I have right here does not have any RGB, no LEDs even actually. You do have your light indicators up there for like your cap locks and all that, but no RGB here. You can get one with RGB, but of course it's gonna increase your price. But me personally, I like that subtle look that we have right here. All right, so now let's get into the nitty gritty here as far as the sound test. By the way, I have cherry reds on here. No mods, this is out of the box stock. So two things you might have noticed right there in the sound test, at least in person you can really notice. Number one, the most disappointing to me is the ping. It's a ping, kind of a ring. And where that's coming from, I believe, is underneath. Again, you have this whole open body. And you can kind of hear it radiating through there. So instead of just that foam in between the PCB and the plate that they did, I think there should have been some included underneath there. And number two, what you might have noticed, or a lot of people might be jumping to the conclusion of, is, well, cherry switches. A lot of people say they're scratchy, which, I mean, it's mild, guys. When you talk about the scratchy and cherry switch, it's mild. I main cherry speed silvers, because again, I'm a gamer before a keyboard fan, you know. But luckily, with the 1.3s, as far as the minis, the TKLs, the 65%s, whatever, we have hot swap right here. So let's get a couple keycaps off, get our keycap puller. By the way, this keycap puller is just jumbo and very firm. I stink and love it right there. So anyways, we got our cherry red out. They come with 3-pin switches, as you can see, but getting closer, our PCB is actually a 5-pin. If you can see those two little yellow dots in there are showing you the extra pins, which is really stinking awesome, because you're going to be able to fit just about any switch on this right there. Really cool. Now looking even closer into the board right here, as far as our stabilizers, they are plate mount and they're in there very firm, barely any movement around as far as a stabilizer into the plate. Now the actual stem itself, if you can see here in the camera, I mean, just the slightest tap and it's quite dancey, which is why I think we get that sound with them, because again, they're really dancing. There's just about no lube on these stabs as well. All right, so let's wrap this up, guys. Straight out the gate, this keyboard comes in at $110. This version I have right here, no RGB, right? And again, it will climb up as far as switch you decide, color variation, or ones with RGB. I believe they go up to like $150, maybe a few bucks more. But as far as the one I have right here, which is how I prefer my boards, $110. And wow, guys, even the minor flaws, I think the sides, hopefully that was just my copy right there. As far as the pinging, I think we're gonna be able to fix that pretty easily. Subscribe, hit the bell, because we're gonna dabble into this board a little more in a future video. But at $110, it might have taken over the number one spot in that video. I think it would have taken a number one spot. Okay, I know it would have taken a number one spot. But I really do hope, and I'm pretty sure they're gonna, at least I really want them to, is to make a solid white version, a solid black version. They already had that solid yellow version. So I don't know, maybe they're getting all their crazy colors out and then they're coming out with the solid ones. And that will be absolutely fantastic. But anyways, there we go. The Ducky 1.3 TKL. What a fantastic board. Let me know what you thought about it right down in the comments, and thank you so much for stopping by and watching this video. Hope I helped you out. If I did, hit that thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. Hey, hope to catch you in the next one. Bye now.